A brand new update for Borderlands 3 is out now, plus a new hotfix that nerfs already pretty weak bosses and changes some skills. I will tell you everything you need to know, and I also check if the offline tactics, including the XP and legendary farm spots, still work after this update. So let's get into it. Would be awesome if you could leave a like on the video, as it really helps the channel out. And let's go. Let's start with the small update that you see me download right here. This just includes some small fixes, including for the Hollow Point Guardian rank that now has been re-enabled. First, we had the red text. Well, we can use it again right now if you spent 75 Guardian tokens in the Enforcer row. So if you got this one, then killing an enemy with a critical hit causes an explosion around them, but now this will no longer damage allies. I sadly don't have this one unlocked yet. I am close though. No, I only have the Hunter and the Survivor row unlocked at this point. But I know that it was very unreliable before, so it's great that they changed it. They mentioned that they addressed a reported issue where some players' inventory would not be saved in their bank. I think this is regarding the bug where your bank would just be wiped. This happened to some players. I saw some Reddit posts and they were very scary. So hopefully that is fixed right now with this update. It seems like it. And then we got two very specific fixes, where the Ultimate Vault Hunter achievement on Xbox would not work, and where your mouse functionality would be lost after joining a friend's session on PC. So good to note is that these changes are for everyone after downloading this update. And I can happily say, by the way, that the legendary farm tactics still work if you play offline. So you can still farm the loot tank in the Jacob's Estate region on Eden 6. This one spawns over here on the map. And when I tried this, when I had update 1.03 installed, I even found 4 loot tanks in this region. So 2 even before the guaranteed one, then the guaranteed one, and then later in Jacob's Estate itself, I also found another one that I actually never encountered before. So again, this only works when you boot up the game offline, and you also still get the insane amount of XP if you play on the Mayhem mode 3. But I think this all ends when the upcoming Day 30 update will be released. This will at least include the EchoCast extension for Twitch for the console, and also the photo mode that is already on the PC, but not yet on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. Day 30 update, so like 2 weeks from now, something like that. Gearbox said that they will share more information on the exact release date and the content soon. Now on to the fixes that are only applied if you have the hotfix, so when you play the game online. Let's stay in the Jacob's Estate region, where we actually find Billy the Anointed, who I never really had an issue with, but they did reduce the health of this boss by 25%. Just like the health from Gigamind, one of the first bosses, has also been slightly decreased. And they made the Katagawa ball easier too, because it will now no longer regenerate its shield. I never really had issues with these bosses, also on Mayhem mode 3, as you see right here, we kill them pretty easily. But I think these changes are mostly for people during their first playthrough, where maybe some people were having issues fighting this boss. Totally let me know if you maybe had issues with the boss, or if you found them easy too. Let me know in the comments down below. This one is interesting. NPCs in the slaughter maps were reported to sometimes attempt to automatically revive players in the arena. Going forward, they will no longer attempt to revive players. What? Did they do that? That's really, really weird. If you ever had that, totally let me know. So, Amara's glamour skill first did not really work always as intended. So the idea is that after an action skill, the enemies will fight each other, but they would still sometimes also fight you. Well, I think that with this change, they should now only fight each other. And speaking of class changes, we got changes for Flak. Because, of course, we need changes for Flak every week. So we got some buffs, for example, for the Barbaric Yop skill, that now doubles the amount of pet bonuses you will get. So you get more movement speed or damage, for example, depending on the pet you have. A pretty nice increase. They really want you to use the Rack Attack skill. It's now better because it always applies the status effect when used, depending on the incendiary damage or the cryo variant that you use. But yeah, the Flak crit build gets another nerf with the Leave No Trace skill that had a chance to give you ammo back after a crit. this now has a delay of 2 seconds. So you cannot get ammo back all the time, only once per 2 seconds. So yes, that means that reloading during your fadeaway will likely happen more often. The means of destruction for most has also a re-trigger delay of 2 seconds. This is to combat the infinite grenade build that Gearbox says is funny, but doesn't really work as intended. So if you still want to spam infinite grenades, then you can just play offline, because these changes I noted here only apply when you play the game online and have the hotfix installed. So you can still go back to how things were by just booting up the game offline and ignoring that update notification in the options menu. So then, for as long as you don't go to the main menu, you will not have these changes. Subscribe for everything Borderlands 3. I will keep you up to date on all the updates, and of course also have tips and tricks and guides up on the channel and more coming your way. Totally check out my previous video on some awesome best weapons that you totally want to get. You can watch it by clicking on the screen, or I will link to it at the end of our golden chest opening that we always like to do here at the end of a Borderlands 3 video. What do you have on your back, Dennis?
What do you mean, what do I have on my back?
That insane rocket launcher. Shoot it one time.
This one, yeah. I'll shoot it over there so you can see what it does.
Oh. Oh. It's like fireworks.
Yes, all over the place.
Nice. Let's hopefully get some fireworks out of the golden chest as well. Let's see. Why do I always have the purples? I only have purples these days. It's annoying.
Well, maybe next time.
Maybe next time. Subscribe for way more Borderlands tips and tricks. I will keep you up to date on all the Borderlands news, updates, and stuff like that. So totally subscribe, like the video to support the channel, and check out the previous video on some best weapons you totally want to get. For now, though, we will speak to you next time, and goodbye.